Hello, I'm Ilian Saint-Hilaire, and in this video, we're going to talk about code signing the Mesh Agent binary. When you run the Mesh Agent on a remote computer, you may have noticed that there's a warning by Windows. Obviously, this is for Windows machines, there's a warning that says that this agent does not come from a known source. And so the solution is to sign the agent with a certificate, and you can do that using your own code signing certificate. So we're just going to discuss this in this video. Now, first of all, this is my trusty developer server here, and the first thing you'll want to talk about is what agent comes with the server when you download it. So it comes with an agent that is self-signed. So I'm going to go to my download folder here. I'm going to download the agent, and I'm going to take Windows 64-bit, say save, and I'm going to download the agent. I'm going to right-click on it and say properties, and in digital signature, you'll see that there's a certificate that signs the agent, but this is not a trusted certificate. It's actually a self-signed cert, and the root of this certificate, the public part of the root, is actually available. So I'm going to go inside MeshCentral here, and agents. So in MeshCentral agents, there's a file called codesign.cert, and this is actually the certificate that is used to sign the agent, at least just a public part of it. So if you want to trust this certificate, then obviously the agents as is would be trusted. But it's possible to go and get yourself a code signing certificate. Large organizations have that, and you would code sign the agent correctly. So the agents, if you look in the node modules MeshCentral agents folder, you'll find all the agent binaries, but the most important are the mesh command signed and the agent signed binaries. These are the four files that are signed using the self-signed root cert. And these mesh service here and mesh service 64, these are the unsigned ones, but we can just take the signed one and re-sign them. So let's go ahead and do that. I'll grab the 64-bit version of the agent, like this one here, and I'm going to create a new temporary folder. I'll just call it temp. And I'm going to copy the agent right there. And I'm going to open myself a command prompt, go to the temp folder, and this is where I'm going to sign the agent. Now, to sign the agent, you will need a code signing certificate. A Let's Encrypt certificate will not do. A website HTTPS or TLS certificate, those will not do. And you can't get a code signing certificate for free. You have to pay money for it, and they will have to verify your identity, make sure who you are, because the certificate name, the information on the certificate needs to be legitimate. So once you have that certificate, usually you load it in your certificate store. You may also, the certificate provider may give you a USB key that has it or so on. So you need to get inside that setup. And then what you'll do is you'll use the sign tool. This is a tool provided by Microsoft to sign the agent. You'll provide the hash of the certificate. This is just to tell the sign tool, this is the hash of, this is the certificate I want to use to sign it. Of course, the sign operation. And then you'll, in my case, I use SHA-384 for pretty much anything MeshCentral related. So that's my hashing algorithm. You can specify a URI, a description, and then the file you want to sign. So that's all correct here. So what you do, actually what I'm going to do is open that back up. I'm going to grab this command, and I'm just going to demonstrate what code signing looks like. So I'm going to, let's see here, copy this, paste it there, and hit enter. Let's see, file not found. Oh, of course, I need to put the right file name. So right there, paste it, and enter. Successfully signed. There you go. So once it's successfully signed, you can right-click again, take a look at the digital signature, and you'll see signature. Now, I sign with a timestamp, but so there's additional options to get a timestamp provider online that will also timestamp the signature. But here I signed it without a timestamp, and so that's what it looks like. Okay, so that's cool. Now, once you have signed your agent, you can put it in a special folder in MeshCentral. So the problem with putting it inside the node module, so if you go in MeshCentral, normally you would have a node modules folder with the MeshCentral underneath there. And any changes you make there, as soon as you update MeshCentral, you'll lose those changes. So if you go into node modules, MeshCentral agents, and you modify the agent here and put your new signed agent, well, as soon as you upgrade MeshCentral, that will get wiped out. So the alternative is that you will go to MeshCentral data. So you take your MeshCentral data folder, you create a new folder underneath there called agents, and you put your signed agent right there. So, and it must have the same file name as the MeshCentral, inside MeshCentral folder, the agents right there. There's a whole bunch of agents here. And so what you do is you create a folder called agents with exactly the same name as agents here, and then you put your own file there. So what happens is that when you restart MeshCentral, and there you go, what happens is that when you download the 64-bit version of the agent, in my case, it will pick it up from this folder instead of the default one. So what I'm going to do is go to my download folder. So now here I have a signature with a timestamp because that's the one that comes with MeshCentral. I'm going to delete this, and I'm going to download the agent again, say save. Now it should, there you go. See, there's no timestamp, and that's because I now downloaded my copy of it inside MeshCentral data agents folder, not the default one. So this is great for companies that want to sign the agent and still upgrade MeshCentral while keeping their signed agent. But there's one more caveat here. The problem with signing the agent is that anybody who gets the binary of your agent could use it with their own server. Like, this agent is not locked to your server. So in theory, you can sign it, but it could still be misused. So ideally what you want to do is sign the agent in a way that makes it so that the agent can only talk to your server and no other server. So that, basically lock the binary to your server. And so with the new agent, and I'm talking about the agent that has the new user interface. So I'm gonna do run anyway like this here. So if your agent has the new user interface that is blue with the icon, right, like this, then this agent supports signature with locking to your server. So I'm gonna demonstrate that now. I'm gonna go back to my temporary folder right here. And what I'm gonna do is download the MSH file. Now, the MSH file is a little file that tells the agent where to connect and which device group to connect to. Now, normally the MSH file is embedded inside the executable, and then when you install it, it shows up during the install. But if you run MeshCentral with interrogation port debug equal one, if you run MeshCentral webpage with debug equal one, you can click add agent and you'll see the MSH link is right there. So I'm gonna download this. And basically, by downloading this into my download folder, I'm gonna take a look at it. I'm gonna open Visual Studio here and take a look at this MSH. And what we'll notice is that there's the server identifier, the server URI, and the device group identifier. So these are the three things that are super important. The rest of the translations, that's for internationalizing strings, and this is generally ignored. So the URI, this tells the agent what URI to connect to your server. The server ID is a cryptographic hash of the certificate of the server. It's a SHA-384 hash, and it's all uppercase. And so this is used by the agent to verify that the server is really the legitimate one, that it's not an imposter. So if somebody were to grab your domain name, the agents would still not be able to connect to the server. And then the mesh ID, this is the device group identifier. This is, you know, which device group should the agent initially connect to. Okay, so what we're going to focus on is the URI here, and especially the DNS name, this name right there, and the server ID right there. So what I want to do is sign the agent so that it will only connect to this DNS name and only connect if the server matches this identifier. And so I want to do that. So what I'm going to do is go back to my notes right there. So this is the command I use to sign the agent. What I'm going to do is I'm going to focus on this URI right here. Now, if the agent is signed with a very specific URI syntax, then the agent will be locked. And by the way, what I'm going to do is before I re-sign it, I'm going to run the mesh agent dash info, and you're going to see the detected URI, the architecture, the commit date, and so on. There's some information here. Okay, so this is before we sign it with the lock. Now, what I'm going to do is say HTTPS, and I'm going to take this domain name, this DNS name, I'm going to put it as the URI, and then I'm going to put interrogation point server ID in lowercase equal, and then I'm going to put this server ID in uppercase right there. Okay, in the description, you can put anything you want. Also, what you can do is you can put, you know, slash info or slash, you know, something here, and that's okay. So if you want the user, when they see your signature, when they see the information about the signature, if you want them, when they click on the URI, to go somewhere interesting to get information about your agent or your service, you can add some static data here. But in my case, I'm just going to do this. So so HTTP, the DNS name, server ID, and the full identifier. Okay, so I'm going to take this, copy the command, I'm going to paste it right here. Now, did I actually, I need to correct the file name again. Put the right file name. There you go. Say enter. Boom. Successfully signed. Now, if I run dash info again on this agent, you will see the same information as before, but it will say locked to, and then the DNS and the server identifier that this agent is locked to. So that means this agent will not ever be able to connect to another server. So then what you do is you take this agent executable, put it in your MeshCentral-data slash agents folder. People can download it, and you are safe in knowing that this binary cannot be misused. So just as a quick demonstration, I'm going to take the MSH file, and I'm going to copy it in my temp folder, and I'm just going to name it the same as the agent. There you go. Now I'm going to run the agent. Okay, and it worked, okay? Now what I'm going to do is modify the MSH. So I'm going to close these two things, modify the MSH, and I'm going to put ABC in front of the domain name right here. Now I'm going to run the agent again. Won't run anymore. Refused. And so it will refuse to open the dialog box if the MSH is wrong. Or by the way, the same for the server ID. If I change this D to an E and run, won't work. If I change it back to a D, there you go. Now it works. And and it's not just that it won't open the dialog box, is that even if you got it to run, it won't connect unless it's connecting to, if you look at connection server details, unless the DNS of the URI matches the DNS of the signature, and the server identifier matches the server identifier of the signature. That's the only time it will connect. Now, the other thing I recommend is once you sign this, just be careful not to verify. Grab this binary, replace one of the machines with this binary, the signed binary, make sure it works, it connects correctly to your server, and so on. The worst thing you want to do is sign it with an incorrect lock. So, you know, you sign it with a bad URI here, and then you cause somehow an update of all your agents with an agent that has an invalid lock, and now none of your agents will connect to the server because they are locked to a wrong DNS name or a wrong server ID. So just make sure that when you sign it, you always sign and you always verify that you signed it with the right DNS and the right server ID. Make sure that you always use the right syntax. So, HTTPS, //, the DNS name, server ID in small case, and then the entire ID in uppercase. So hopefully that was useful. I think this feature will allow people to sign the agent, make sure their binary is trusted, that it only connects to their server, and so it can't be misused for any reason. I would recommend that everybody do this. Always use the lock. If you don't use this exact syntax in the URI, then there's no lock, and then the agent can be used anywhere. Hopefully that was useful. Thank you very much. Have a great day.